Hey friends, welcome back to the channel. Another week, another video. And today we're talking about Gatorade's new GX recovery app and their whole system with the sweat patches and stuff. So let's get right into it. So I originally discovered Gatorade GX because of an Instagram ad that I saw because I waste too much time on Instagram. And I reached out to Gatorade's marketing team to see if they would be willing to send out some information as well as potentially some products for me to review. And because of you guys, my awesome subscribers, they decided to accept and they sent out this box that I opened on Instagram for those of you who are following over there, and I was able to test it. So if you want me to be able to continue to review products like this and continue to reach out to brands who are able to then send these products, please don't forget to give this video a quick thumbs up. And I really appreciate it. Okay, so inside the box, I got the Gatorade GX app explainer text, which is kind of nice. I got 4 GX sweat patches. I got this cool little Gatorade GX bottle, which turns out is customizable, even though I don't have a customizer. Maybe I'll do that eventually. And it also came with this cool Gatorade towel and some other awesome things from Gatorade. So combining the obvious, you know, Gatorade stuff where you've got the bottle, you've got the pods that turn into Gatorade. I downloaded the app, and once you download the app, you can see a quick login screen. It asks you if you've worked out today, and then it lets you connect things like Apple Health and potentially Strava to bring in any workouts that you do. Now, it also asks you if you want to schedule a workout at that time, which I did, of course. So you schedule it, and then it starts to recommend things like hydration and protein and carbs so that you know how to prep for your workout, how to fuel during your workout, and then post-workout, how you can rehydrate and re-energize. You also choose at this point when you're scheduling a workout whether you're going to be using the sweat patch, which I was going to, and then it makes recommendations of how to use it. Obviously, this being my first time, I read through those, and keep in mind, we're going to talk about this in a second because it's super relevant, but they tell you that you can work out between 45 and I think it was 95 degrees. Now, that's kind of important if you live in Arizona and it can regularly get above 95 degrees, especially I think we're in April right now, so I had to be aware of that and definitely work out in the morning. It also recommends on this screen to work out between 20 and 120 minutes for the sweat patch to accurately register. So this is the Gatorade GX sweat patch. And the patch itself is pretty cool. It shows you your sweat rate as well as your sodium content in your sweat. So the orange line, if you can see that on the screen, is what's going to tell you your sweat rate. And then the purple line in the corner is going to tell you your sodium concentration within your sweat. So that's actually pretty cool. And I think the information is a gold mine. I think Gatorade is really onto something here, and that's the main idea I got from this entire review, is they're super, super close to something awesome, and I think this could really be valuable to all athletes, not just the professionals, but there are some reasons why they didn't absolutely nail it on this try, but I think this could be V1, and that's why this review is being called Review Part 1, because I really hope that Gatorade can fix some of the things that I recommend here, and potentially, I'll do a Review Part 2, where those things have been fixed. Okay, so now that we're in the app, we've scheduled our workout, we've learned about the GX sweat patch, now it shows you some of the recommendations. It's talking to you about hydration, it's talking to you about carbs and things like that. So these recommendations are fine-tuned over time based on the results from your sweat patch, based on weigh-ins, before and after your workouts, you can semi-accurately determine like fluid loss during your workout, and other things like temperature, which it also dynamically pulls in from the weather report, which I thought was pretty cool. Okay, so it's just about time to head out the door and go for a workout, but I really wanted to talk about some of the key items that they put inside the box as things that they're doing well and what they're trying to do with this whole GX app and recovery system. So they're leaning on 35 years of Gatorade experience in sports science, which I think is awesome. And as I mentioned before, I really think they're onto something here. I think understanding recovery for the general athlete is incredibly valuable. Things like the Whoop, and you've probably seen some of my reviews on the Whoop, it really goes to show that understanding your recovery and understanding your strain is incredibly important for performing at your best, avoiding injury and potentially recovering even faster. So now that I've talked probably just a little too much, now it's time to head out for a run and test this GX sweat patch and the GX recovery app. Hey guys, checking in halfway through the run, 15 minutes in. It's a 30-minute run, which was recommended by Gatorade for the first initial test of the sweat patch. So here we go.
I've only been out for 15 minutes, and as you can see, my sweat patch is kind of hard to tell, but the sweat patch is starting to fill up. I know I saw some reviews from other creators that have done like yoga workouts and things like that and haven't gotten any sweat to register on the band at all, so it's kind of nice to see something. But I also got the recommendation to have 10 to 30 grams of carbs during my run, and it's just a 30-minute morning run, but hey, it's the review, so I got to test everything. I do have these Gatorade chews that I've had for a while. I use them on the bike a lot, but they're 5 grams of carbs each, so if I have three of these, 15, right in between that, maybe it'll make my run that much better. So since this is a review, here we go. I'm gonna finish my run and see you back at the desk.
On that run, the sweat patch did not work at all. It did not scan, it gave me some error with a bunch of weird debug information, and I tested it about 6 times going back and forth to try and see what the problem was, if there was something I could do about it. And I came to the determination after searching online and trying to figure this out that it was because I worked out for 25 minutes, which is above, if you remember, the 20-minute recommendation that they give for the sweat patch, but below the 30-minute recommendation that they give online and in some other places in the app. So there's some inconsistencies there that I would say Gatorade would probably be something you should fix. I didn't know that I needed to work out for 30 minutes. I tried to just do the quick, easy 20-25-minute workout, and it did not work. So that's something I would recommend to fix. And I should say at this point, I have reached out to Gatorade for a specific response and they have not yet responded, but I will drop a comment in this video's comment section if they do end up responding after I publish this video. Okay, so the super unfortunate thing about this patch not working is that these sweat patches are one-time use and they cost about $13 each. So if you go for a run and you try to use the sweat patch and it doesn't work and it crashes like this, that's a big problem. And it's really frustrating for an athlete if they paid $13 for this product and then it does not work. So Gatorade, I would again say that that's something you should probably look into, but I did take another sweat patch and I went out again, this time on a bike ride to test it out. Now this bike ride was about 40 minutes, so it was definitely above the threshold that I needed to do. And when I scanned the patch, it did succeed. So that worked smoothly. The only problem I had in this second trial is that when I took off the patch, my arm was orange. I had orange marks all over my arm, and even after showering, you might be able to see it, probably not in this video, but my arm is still a little bit orange, and that's kind of a problem. It's probably not something that's going to negatively affect me, but it is a little bit weird and not something that I would recommend for a big brand like Gatorade to have that bleeding its little orange juices all over your arm. It's not awesome. Okay, so I talked about a couple of things, and I talked about how the GX recovery app works. And one of the cool things about when you get off your workout and you get your recommendation about hydration is that you have these cool little GX pods that you can use when you're ready to recover. So you can put this into your awesome, potentially customized GX bottle here, and it'll turn into Gatorade. So it's really just pretty much the same as normal Gatorade. It wasn't anything special. When I tried it, it tastes like Gatorade. The cool thing is when you put it in, you pop the top of this bottle and it lets you just smash the top of this little Gatorade pod into it. But I should say, while it does look really cool and it looks like a little Gatorade shot that you could just drink and then get all the sodium concentration and thirst quenching that you need, I would not recommend it. It tastes horrible if you just try it without water. So put it in water. Don't be dumb. Don't try and drink the Gatorade pod all on its own. It's just a bad idea. Okay, so I talked about some of my recommendations. I talked about some of the things that I love about this Gatorade new GX recovery app, and I really do think that it's something awesome that they are potentially landing on a gold mine here. I think they need to improve integrations. I think this information could be integrated with a lot of cool services like Strava, like Whoop, and potentially others, but some of the recommendations were a little bit odd. For example, I finished a workout and it told me to drink 7 ounces of fluid before the end of the day. 7 ounces is less than a cup. That just seems really odd. So little recommendation changes like that, I would say, are important. Also, the user interface, a lot of reviews similar to this one have said the interface is just not very usable. I kind of used it as more of a secondary interface where I'm using something like Strava or Whoop or any other exercise app. And then Gatorade is really just more of a reference for recovery. So it didn't have that much of an issue for me. But I think if you can bring a lot of those recommendations from the Gatorade GX app into other apps, where you can see what kind of recommended recovery you need, hydration, protein, carbs, anything like that, would be very valuable. So at the end of the day, I would say it's really cool. I don't think these sweat patches are worth what they're charging for them right now, unfortunately, especially because it seems like they're still almost like a beta test of this patch because it's bleeding that orange stuff onto my arm and potentially not working half the time. I think that that needs to be significantly cheaper. But understanding your sweat profile and calculating that sweat profile for a specific workout that you can then use later to calculate recovery is a very valuable idea that they can definitely lean on to build something super awesome. So I hope this video was enjoyable and that it was helpful to you. If it was, don't forget to give it a quick thumbs up and subscribe to the channel if you haven't already, because that way you'll see the future videos that I come out with, especially next week when I'm going to be publishing a video that I've been working on for the past month. So hopefully you will enjoy that and have a great rest of your day.